Good morning, dear students. Welcome back to our chemistry class. Do you remember which lesson we are studying? Yes, lesson 6, physical change and chemical change. And we have already discussed what is physical change. Now I have one paper, okay, one A4 sheet, and now I am folding it. And my question is it physical change? Before that, you have to remember what is physical change and what are physical properties. So, physical change, we have already studied definition as a substance undergoes change in its physical properties. That change is physical change. Here, we know that I folded this paper, isn't it? So, there is a change in its size. So, we have known size is a physical property. So, there is a change in its size. Okay. So, folding of paper is an example for physical change. Next, suppose that I am burning this paper with a matchstick. Is it physical change? Not at all. So, that change we have to study today. So, today we are going to study another change, that is chemical change. So, let us watch this video. A chemical change is a permanent change in which an entirely new substance is formed. Example, formation of curd, growing of seedlings from the seed. Burning of fuels, etc. are examples of chemical changes. So, we can conclude in chemical change, the first point, one or more entirely new substance is formed. The change is permanent. The change may be reversible or irreversible. Change in the composition and properties of the substance takes place. Heat or light may be given out or absorbed. Change is classified into two types. First one, physical change. Second one, chemical change. In physical change, no new substance formed. It is reversible. In chemical change, new substance formed. It is irreversible. So, physical change, we can take the example, boiling of water. Now, the water changes to water vapor. The water vapor actually it is H2O. Now, we can collect the water vapor and if we cool it, we will get again this water. So, there is no change. So, it is an example for physical change. Vaporization of water. The next one is chemical change. Here we can take the example as making of omelette. We know that omelette we can make from raw egg. And from the omelette we cannot make again egg back. Okay. So it is an example for chemical change. A new substance that is omelette formed here. So, we can conclude what are the differences between physical change and chemical change. In physical change, only physical properties like shape, size, color, state, etc. change. Here, internal structure of the substance changes. In physical change, no new substance is formed. In chemical change, new substance is formed. Physical change reversible normally. And chemical change irreversible one. And physical change is temporary, but chemical change is permanent one. In physical change, energy changes small, but in chemical change, energy change large. Then mass of substance remains same in physical change,
But in chemical change, mass of substance changes. So these are the differences between physical change and chemical change. And here also, heat, light, sound not produced in physical change, but in chemical change, heat, light, sound also produced. Physical change example, melting of ice. Here chemical change example, burning of wax. Some more examples, melting of ice cream, cutting lemon, dissolving salt or sugar, melting ice cubes. Then example for chemical change, burning matchstick, rusting of iron, cooking an egg, baking a cake.
Hope you understood what are the differences between physical change and chemical change. And today you have one activity. I will give some changes. You have to classify them as physical change and chemical change. Please write in your notebook and send me the photo. Okay, thank you.